Hello. Finally, we'll finish the financial statements with the statement of cash flows. In this video, we'll learn about the cash flow statement and how to prepare it. But wait! If you are new to my channel, please give me a like, subscribe, and leave a comment. Are you ready? Let's begin. What's a cash flow statement? A cash flow statement is an important tool used to manage finances by tracking the cash flow for an organization. This statement is one of the three key reports with the income statement and the balance sheet that help in determining a company's performance. It is usually helpful for making cash forecasts to enable short-term planning. Classification of cash flows. The statement of cash flows classifies cash receipts and cash payments as operating, investing, and financing activities. Transactions and other events characteristic of each kind of activity are as follows. 1. Operating activities include the cash effects of transactions that create revenues and expenses. They thus enter into the determination of net income. 2. Investing activities include A. Acquiring and disposing investments and property, plant and equipment, and B. Lending money and collecting the loans. 3. Financing activities include A. Obtaining cash from issuing debt and repaying the amount borrowed, and B. Obtaining cash from stockholders, repurchasing shares and paying dividends. Operating activities, income statement items. Cash inflows from sale of goods or services, from interest received and dividends received. Cash outflows to suppliers for inventory, to employees for services, to government for taxes, to lenders for interest, to others for expenses. Investing activities, changes in investments and long-term assets. Cash inflows from sale of property, plant and equipment, from sale of investments in debt or equity securities of other entities, from collection of principal on loans to other entities. Cash outflows to purchase property, plant and equipment, to purchase investments in debt or equity securities of other entities, to make loans to other entities. Financing activities, changes in long-term liabilities and stockholders' equity. Cash inflows from sale of common stock, from issuance of long-term debt, bonds and notes. Cash outflows to stockholders as dividends, to redeem long-term debt or reacquire capital stock, treasury stock. Significant non-cash activities. Not all of company's significant activities involve cash. Examples of significant non-cash activities are 1. Direct issuance of common stock to purchase assets. 2. Conversion of bonds into common stock. 3. Direct issuance of debt to purchase assets. 4. Exchanges of plant assets. Companies do not report in the body of the statement of cash flow significant financing and investing activities that do not affect cash. Instead, they report these activities in either a separate schedule at the bottom of the statement of cash flows or in a separate note or supplementary schedule to the financial statements. How can we prepare the statement of cash flows? We want these sources to prepare the statement of cash flows. 1. Comparative balance sheets. 2. The current income statement. 3. Selected transaction data. Preparing the statement of cash flows from these sources involves 4 steps. 1. Determine the net cash provided by or used in operating activities. 2. Determine the net cash provided by or used in investing and financing activities. 3. Determine the change, increase or decrease in cash during the period. 4. reconcile the change in cash with the beginning and the ending cash balances. Analysis of comparative balance sheet reveals that two items that will affect the computation of net cash provided by operating activities. One, the increase in accounts receivable reflects a non-cash increase of $41,000 in revenues. The increase in accounts payable reflects a non-cash increase of $12,000 in expenses. Therefore, to arrive at net cash provided by operating activities, we deduct from the net income the increase in accounts receivable, $41,000, and add back to net income the increase in accounts payable, $12,000. As a result of these adjustments, the company determines net cash provided by operating activities to be $10,000. Next, the company determines its investing and financing activities. Telemarketing Inc.'s only investing activities was the land purchase. It had two financing activities. One, common stock increased $50,000 from the issuance of 50,000 shares for cash. Two, the company paid $40,000 cash in dividends. Knowing the amount provided or used by operating, investing, and financing activities, the company determines the net increase in cash. The increase in cash of $31,000 reported in the statement of cash flows agrees with the increase of $31,000 in cash calculated from the comparative balance sheets. Before we go to the example, I'll give you a summary of how to prepare a statement of cash flows. Any increase in assets is deducted and any increase in liabilities is added, and vice versa. Depreciation and amortization expenses added to the net income. Any change in current assets other than cash and current liabilities affect operating activities in the statement of cash flows. Any change in non-current assets affect investing activities in the statement of cash flows. Any change in non-current liabilities and equity other than retained earnings affects financing activities in the statement of cash flows. Now let's move to the example. Presented below is a condensed version of comparative balance sheets for Zobim Meta Corporation for the last 2 years at December 31. And the instruction is, prepare a statement of cash flows for 2022. For Zobim Meta Corporation. We will start with calculation field to determine which account is increased and which is decreased. And don't forget that we have additional information. Let's start with them. But before that, place the titles and arrange the statement of cash flows into its three activities. Cash flows from operating activities, cash flows from investing activities, cash flows from financing activities. Let's begin with the net income. It was $160,000. It's the first item in the statement. Then write, adjustments to reconcile net income to net cash provided by operating activities. We have here, investments were sold at a loss, not extraordinary, of $10,000. If we turn back to the comparative balance sheet, we'll note that the investments decreased by $22,000. This amount is divided into two parts. $10,000 loss in the operating activities and $12,000 in the investing activities. As we see here, the loss is added to the net income. And the $12,000 is added to the investing activities as sale of investments. No equipment was sold. We note here that the equipment increased, so we deduct it from the investing activities. The last item in additional information is cash dividends paid, were $30,000. Just deduct it from the financing activities. After finishing, we turn back to the comparative balance sheets to proceed with the rest of the accounts. As we know that the change in cash will appear at the end of the statement. The decrease of accounts receivable is added to the operating activities. The difference in accumulated depreciation represents the depreciation expense. It will be added to the operating activities. The decrease of current liabilities is deducted from the operating activities. There is no change in common stock, so no effect on the statement. The retained earnings account doesn't affect the statement. 17 plus 10 plus 5 minus 17 equals 15. The net cash provided by operating activities is 160 plus 15 equals $175,000. The net cash used by investing activities is 12 minus 58 equals minus $46,000. The net cash used by financing activities is minus $30,000. 175 minus 46 minus 30 equals $99,000. The net increase in cash. Add cash at the beginning of the year, $78,000. The result is cash at the end of the year, $177,000. That's all for today. If you like this video, please leave a comment and share it. See you soon.